Tackling weeds during harvest by diverting chaff and weed seeds into permanent tramlines is one of the tools Scaddan grower Mark Wandel is using in his controlled traffic farming system. With herbicides one of his biggest input costs on farm, Mr. Wandel is using a variety of tools to help not only control ryegrass, but prevent herbicide resistance.
Spending around $118 a hectare on total herbicides across the farm per year, that includes all our summer spraying as well. So yeah, we rotate our herbicides around with newer chemistry, so we're using some of the more expensive, the Securas, and we did have a heavy reliance on Chaff land 10 years ago. We sort of backed that right off as well, trying to rotate all our herbicides around now and mix things up to more to a degree.
And while crop and chemical rotations play an important part in weed management, Mr. Wandel is also seeing positive results using a system he calls chaff tramlining. Through a modified chaff deck on his New Holland harvesters, Mr. Wandel can divert chaff and weed seeds into a single compacted tramline rather than both tramlines.
We just pick up all the chaff and it comes down the tray, and then we've got about a 550-wide belt that runs 90 degrees. And we can change direction of that belt, so we pick up the hydraulic flow off the chaff. Yeah, we've got the belt in there, and the belt can drop it either left or right, so we change the direction of our conveyors, so we're always dropping it onto our western side tram lines, so we're just trying to concentrate our weed seeds further.
Mr. Wandel and his wife Hayley are part of a family farming business which comprises 5,300 hectares at Scaddan and 1,700 hectares at Beaumont, northwest of Esperance in southern Western Australia. Since introducing the chaff tramlining system into their continuous cropping operation, the Wandels have reduced the need to spray out tramlines.
It's just another tool in the toolbox for us for weed management. It just gives us the opportunity, trying to touch, instead of spreading all our weed seeds out over the paddock again, if they're going through the header, we can catch them, and we're just taking them from putting them on our productive part of our paddocks and just trying to direct them into our least productive parts of the paddock in the tram line. And then from there, they're in a very hostile environment where it's compacted, it gets wet, dries out quick, and then we drive back over them again in crop. We know exactly where they are, so we can come back and use other controlled methods.